Hey butterflies, welcome back to Tana and Life. Hope you're doing well. Today I have the third episode of Our Blindness Reality for you. On this episode, I'll be talking about how to guide a blind or visually impaired person. But before we get to that, if you're new here, I just want to say hello and welcome. My name is Ella, and on this channel, I share my life adventures through my tunnel vision eyes, and I do contents like lifestyle, travel, unboxing, vlogs, and more as I strive to provide education and information while spreading awareness about the blind and visually impaired community in my own little way, especially through my series called Our Blindness Reality. I really would appreciate if you'll consider joining my Butterfly Squad community and joining me in my journey as I try to live my visually impaired life to the fullest by subscribing to this channel today. Thank you so much for being here. Now let's get started. Today's Our Blindness Reality episode is gonna be a little bit different because you're only gonna be seeing and hearing me today. My Lighthouse Butterfly Squad friends will not be in this episode today. That's just because episode 2 and episode 3 are basically connected to each other. If you missed it, I will link the episode 2 in the description below. We talked about the do's and don'ts and how to interact with a blind or visually impaired person, plus some experiences in that video. So definitely check that out before. All right, so the number one thing that you really need to know to be a proper human or sighted guide, especially to a stranger, you know, outdoors or something, is to approach them nicely and kindly, introduce yourself, and ask them if they want or need the help. Now, always do please respect if they do decline and say no. Just be aware that not all blind and VI person is gonna want or need the help. In my case though, I did mention that I prefer like having a human or sighted guide in previous videos on this channel, but I only really do that with friends and family. So the asking part is probably the only thing that matters to me here, because I will know who they are and everything. So that's just my take on that. So my experience, after your help has been accepted or asked for, the second thing you need to do now is offer your arm to that person. The way you do that is you either tap your hand on the back of their hand so they can guide their own hands around your elbow area, or you can stand close to them and put your arm in a 90-degree angle and then basically tap your elbow closer to their hand so they know where to grab you, and then let them grab your elbow. Never push, pull, or grab the person. This is not a good idea at all. So the way they're gonna grab your elbow is basically like they're holding a soda can. So what that means is the fingers will be inside of your elbow and the thumb will be kind of wrapped around outside of the arm. Next, now that you're walking with the person that you're guiding, make sure that you're walking in a natural, comfortable pace. Don't like walk any slower or any faster, and make sure that the person that you're guiding, their arm is on a relaxed 90-degree angle, and make sure that they're also a little bit to your side and a little bit a few steps behind you. So this way you don't trip over each other and it doesn't make it uncomfortable. And I know I'm very guilty of this. Sometimes I walk faster than my guide and I step on them. So just make sure of that and then you're good while you're walking. Now that you are walking with the person that you are guiding, as a human or sighted guide, the most important thing for you to do now is be aware of your surroundings.
look ahead for obstacles, not only in your walking path, but also the walking path of the person that you are guiding. This is the purpose of you guiding them, so they wouldn't run into those obstacles. So look ahead, but also remember to look at foot, head, and side levels. While you're being aware of your surroundings, make sure to always maintain communication with the person that you're guiding. This will help them understand their surroundings and where they are and stuff like that. And always be specific with your description. This is so important. Next, let's talk about what you as a human or sighted guide should do when encountering stairs. First of all, you should stop at the first step of the stairs and let the person that you are guiding, that stairs are ahead of them, and which way it is going, up or down. And if there are any handrails, let them know which side it is on. So shall they choose to be closer to the handrail and then the opposite side, let them switch. It also might be helpful if you let them know how deep or shallow the steps are or how many. And make sure to don't forget to let them know when they have reached the end of the stairs. That's important too. Bonus tip here, something that's worked for me, something that I appreciate. My best friend Christina started doing this when we were in high school. And this is like personal preference. You don't always have to do this. And I realize this is not always possible too, is you can count the steps that you're going up and down in and let the person that you're guiding how many steps. Now, if it's not possible, because I know a lot of stairs sometimes have so many steps, so just let them know that you're going up and down a lot of steps, or little steps, small steps. Things like that might be really helpful. So again, personal preference there, something that's worked for me. I think it was just worth sharing. You can also do that. Next obstacle that you might encounter are doors. So what you should do is place the person that you are guiding on the hinge side of the door. Let them know the direction the door opens and closes. Also, let them know which side the actual door is, and then walk through the door, and then they will close it with their free hand. Next, when approaching chairs, place the hand of the person that you are guiding on the back of the chair or on the armrest part of the chair. It also might be helpful if you let them know what kind of chair it is that is in front of them or that they're about to sit on. So definitely do that. Next obstacle is when you approach or walk through a narrow space or a crowded place where you need to be in single file. So the way you signal that and the way you let the person that you are guiding know that is by placing the arm that they're holding behind you towards your back. So then they would be walking behind you. And then once you pass that narrow space or crowded place, you then put your arm back to the way that it was to your side. So they know that, you know, they can go back to the normal, to the side and behind you position. The 10th and last thing that I'm going to be talking about in this video to help you become a proper human or sighted guide is to never ever leave person that you are guiding in free space. This is the worst feeling. You never want the person that you're guiding to feel disoriented or lost. So you leave them for a moment or be separated from them for a second, make sure that you are leaving them by a stable object like a wall. That's really important.
Alright, butterflies, that is all for episode 3 of Our Blindness Reality. Hope you enjoyed and learned a little something from today's video. Thank you so much for watching. I will see you on the next one. Don't forget to like and subscribe, and always remember to be kind, spread love, positivity, and good vibes only. Bye, butterflies!